Well, beginning the second rotation is the Chinese competitor, Hui Wanwan.
And Hui has been known as one of the best beam workers in the world and an incredibly complex routine. Change leg leap, wing jump, a little small wobble there. Flip, flip, layout. Normally puts a full twist in there, so obviously she's just coming back to form. She has had a little bit of an injury last year, missed World Championship, so maybe she's just getting back into the swing of things. Her first major competition for some time. Well, I build her up and now she's wobbling. That's a shame. Looking forward to this particular routine. Flip, layout, layout. So she has cut right back on the difficulty level of this routine. Combination there, little wolf jump into a full twisting Corbett. And a double tuck to finish. She sticks the dismount, but she's made too many errors through the other part of the routine.
And really not at the same standard we're used to seeing from her.
And there's that flip, flip, very nice layout, taking nothing away from her. It's still beautifully performed, but we are used to seeing the full twist. And good quality on the dismount.
Perhaps Liz just lacking a little international competition at the moment.
I would think so, yes. She's been out for quite a while last year. This may be her first major meet in a considerable amount of time.
Across on the bars is Alana Slater, and this should become something quite special. She's in 12th position at the moment, but she's got her worst event out of the way, and this, Liz, you'd have to say, is one of her best.
It certainly is. It's probably her most risky in terms of performance, but she has been particularly consistent in training of late, so we hope that pays good dividends.
And who can forget at last year's Nationals, where she scored a perfect 10.
Yes, that was very exciting. Oh, a little bit of a back arch there. So it catches the Jaeger well, a bit flat on the Pak Solto, so she's just going to need to concentrate and get a rhythm back. She's looking a bit out of sorts in terms of her timing on the apparatus here. Hop full, ginga. You'd have to say the difficult part of the routine is over now, but she's just not on the money tonight. Pirouette work. Well, she's going for the double-double. Wow, first girl in Australia to do that.
Oh, well done, Alana Slater. She's gone for the difficulty and it's paid off. The crowd showing their appreciation.
And funnily enough, just in retrospect, I wouldn't be surprised if she's been thinking about that dismount throughout her routine. It's the first time she's ever performed it. Only a handful of girls in the world to be able to do it. And here she is, hop full, a little bit loose in the back, just building a speed up here for the dismount. Double twist, double salto, and what a good landing.
And she looks absolutely delighted, and so she should be.
There's never a good time to try something new, but she's picked a great time for today.
On the vault is Jenny Smith, the 1996 Olympian. On the comeback trail and looking for a second Olympic berth in 2000.
And this would have to be her very strongest apparatus. She was included in last year's World Championship team on the strength of her vaulting.
So Jenny Smith on the vault now.
And she starts with a relatively, or her easier vault of the two vaults, which is the Yurashenko half-turn layout front. Very dynamic vaulter. She's a little bit low on the horse. You can see her contacting in front of the horse instead of right on top. It's not a deduction, but she just doesn't get the same amount of push. You can see the hands almost slipping down, but still fantastic power in the post-flight.
A Jenny Smith preparing for her second vault, a 9.2 in her first attempt. Let's see what she can do here.
Jenny's main aim is just to control her incredible power. Better contact, and what a magnificent vault. I don't know that I've ever seen her perform that better.
And the Aussie girls are putting on a great display here at the Sydney Superdome.
Well, I'd be certainly giving her perfect marks for that. There's very little wrong. Legs squeezed together, perfect body position, and no deductions on the landing. You can see the better contact with the horse, very high from in the post flight, and good distance as well. Gotta be happy with that.
And hasn't she done so well after taking a couple of years out of the sport to come back at this top international level? She really has to be congratulated. And no doubt will be a valuable member of the Australian team come the Olympic Games. Well, we're now looking at Yana Komraskova on the vault. A disappointing floor, looking for an improvement here.
And that's a very nice vault, similar to the one that Esther Moyer does, except she's doing the front salto half out. So she does the Yushchenko entry, half turn on. That's called a Emelianchik front with a half out. Very complicated. She will lose for her leg position in the post-flight, feet apart, and needs to open her body a little bit more before she does the landing.
And a 9.225 for Komraskova's first vault. She was in 30th position out of a field of 32 after the first rotation, so really only one way to go, and that's up. And that is certainly an improvement on her 8.325. Let's see what she does now with the second vault.
She's choosing a handspring front pike with a half turn for her second vault. And that's a very nicely performed vault. 9.6 start value. So there's nice body positions, a good stretch throughout.
The next competitor on
she can
the
spot the landing quite easily. She gets the early turn. You see the floor and control what she is doing on the landing.
Adriana Krysky.
This is Adriana Krysky of Italy on the floor.
Promising junior, came second all around at the 96 Junior Europeans. So she opens with a triple twist, a bit short on the twist itself. Nicely controlled 2.5 twist punch front connected, a 0.2 bonus for that particular connection. Finishing with a whip double pike. Oh, she's lost her footing. What a shame. Otherwise, a very, very nice routine.
Well, let's hope she hasn't hurt herself.
Just her legs seemed to crumble from underneath her. You could see she was going out, maybe just the angle on the floor as she was stepping back.
It looks like there is a bit of a problem there. Let's hope it's not too serious.
There's the first line. Tiny bit short on the twist, but otherwise quite good. These nice leaps and jumps. Plenty of amplitude there. Whip, double pike, and she steps back. She looks like she just rolled her ankle underneath. Unfortunate error.
Let's hope she can continue this competition. She looks to be in quite a bit of pain there. And the score for Krisky, an 8.837. Andreea Izărescu of Romania. Cross on the bars.
And she's perhaps with this apparatus, Romanians are not as strong as on some others. Their composition sometimes lacks in their general body positions while they're swinging. She's looking reasonably good to start. Giant 1.5, that was done nicely, finishing right in handstand and going straight through to Kachev. Paxolto. Giant fall, another giant. Lots of giants in this routine, and a sort of a tuck pike dismount. The bar routine lacking any special qualities in it. It's a bit of a marathon.
And a few form breaks in there too. She found herself in 10th position after the vault.
And there's the Kachev. Compositionally, you'd have to say that this routine is not as strong as some we've seen. Small leg separation, the glide, half-turn glide swing just looks a bit laboured. And the dismount, she seems to tuck her knees as she comes off and then straighten them, so that will be a deduction as well, and it's stiff-legged on the landing too.
On the beam, our first look at Ludovine Fernon, renowned for her work on the floor, but also a good beam worker.
Fernon actually living in the USA right now, followed her coaches who were in France. They moved to USA and she's decided she's better off there with them. And France is number one gymnast at this point. Little cat leap into a side salto. Very hard movement to do correctly. Sideways landings being the most difficult ones on beam. Flip, layout, flip. Leg side leap straight into a shushin over the handstand, and that's quite a nifty little connection. Front salto with a wobble, so not going to get a bonus for the D element. Too bad on the double tuck. Started off strongly, had a couple of little problems.
She didn't look too happy with that performance.
Flip, layout, flip. We're not seeing so many series of three, so it's good to see that from her. Round off, double tuck, low on the landing.
But she did manage to stay on, and on beam, that is all important. A 9.525, a good score for Fernon of France.
Cordini on beam from Ukraine.
She's the competition leader at this stage.
And a series of ring jumps. The Corbett flick. They have to show some elements which go down close to the beam, and that's it for her. Quite a few compositional requirements on every apparatus, 7 to be precise. Front salto, big wobble, at least 0.2 off for that. And quite a few girls seem to be suffering on beam at the moment. Change leg leap, straddle jump, half turn. That was well done. Little cat leap and side somersault. small wobble. She'll probably still get the bonus connection for that. And she's obviously going to do a series for her dismount, accelerating backwards, waiting a long time. Flip, flip, double tuck. Nice dismount.
It certainly was. Haradini, just 15 years of age, and has been touted for big things for a long time. Showed a lot of promise as a junior.
And there's that little cat leap into the side salto. Small wobble.
Well, a 9.6 on the bars, and it's a 9.437 here on the beam. And at this stage, she maintains first position. On the bars, Esther Moyer.
Swing through to reverse grip, full pirouette. And a full pirouette to eagle grip straight to Jaeger. That's an excellent combination. Kachev, small knee bend as she releases and goes over the top of the bar. And swinging in reverse grip now, through to a double front half out. That's an excellent routine. Spanish girls are always well prepared.
Yes, and no strangers to the Australian fans. Esther Moyer, we saw her in action in the Australia versus Spain competition last year. And performing well again here in Sydney.
Straddle past a handstand. Watch for the knees here. Just ever so slight knee bend, maybe a half a tenth off for that. Counter swing to handstand and stooping straight through.
On vault, we have Emily Fournier in fourth position at the moment.
Beautifully done. Plenty of height from the horse. That's the half turn front layout from the round off approach. You can see the round off on back entry, half turn, nice stretch of the hips. And the only noticeable error here is just the small lack of control on the landing. Maybe if the judges got tough, they'd say something about those tiny bit of knees being apart, but very nice vault.
Well, a 9.187 for Fournier's first attempt. She is a power gymnast, Emily Fournier, and particularly strong on floor and vault.
And that same vault with a 1.5 twist this time. Quite often the gymnast will choose a half twist first to get the feeling for the vault and the 1.5 twist after. And a great job. So there's 1.5 twists. And she increases the start value, of course, for that. To 9.8.
Well, she's having a good night so far. A 9.337 for an average of 9.262. We're on the floor now with Jackie Dunn of Australia.
Australia. Representing l'Australie au sol, Jackie Dunn.
Jackie performing at last year's World Championships on three apparatus, everything except for vault, and she just did the most magnificent job. Came through on this apparatus when it counted most. We'd had a small bobble with one of the other team members, and Jackie wasn't even planning to compete, and she went up and did the best routine I've ever seen her do. 1.5 twist step out, through to double pike. Second line here. Oh, two and a half twist, overturned a little bit and lost control, but not such a huge deduction. One tenth for being out of the four and maybe another 1.5. Line coming up, double pike, pretty good on the last line, just the middle tumbling line having trouble, the rest of it quite a nice floor routine.
It certainly was, just that one little mistake. The rest of it very nice from Jackie Dunn.
This is a nice to see the combination, 1.5 twist through to double pike. She's the only girl in Australia showing that 1.5 twist combination. Finishing inside the floor, slightly off direction.
And Jackie Dunn picks up a 9.112. Well, back on the vault and Melinda Cleland. And hopefully this should be something big.
Looking forward to seeing her vault here. She did extremely well at the Australian Championships. Beautiful front layout, too much power, how's that? Very rarely see
pretty
that.
Pretty tough vault to have too much power in, but...
Of course, most girls are struggling to get anywhere near onto their feet in a layout position, and there she is with plenty to spare. That's a good mistake to have if you're going to have one. Ever so slight legs apart, but that's not the biggest problem there, just... We lose about 0.3 or so for the landing steps. It's 0.1 per step.
Well, for that effort, she picks up a 9.287. Let's see if she can improve now with her second vault.
She'll be adding in a half twist into the post flight here. So she's shown she's got plenty of rotation. Adding the half twist in should help her to control it a bit more. Good job. That's a very nice second vault. All she has to do now is look after her landings because the actual technical aspects of those two vaults were outstanding. At this time of the season, it's not such a serious problem. Showing full stretch in the post flight. This is one of the things that the Australian team's going to be looking for is good vaulting performances. It's potentially our weakest apparatus.
Preparing for her performance on the bars is Lisa Skinner. She had a great start on the vault. She's the highest placed Australian at this stage and she's the Commonwealth champion on the bars.
Known for her good body lines. And she's missed that connection there, so she's supposed to do a half turn and she's changed the composition of the routine. She's just going to go into her L-grip giants now. L-grip giant half turn out. And there comes the release, a ginger. So the first part, she's missed some connections. The start value may not end up as high. Let's see what she does for the second half. Looking much stronger now. Giant full. Full in, back out. Tiny bit low on the landing. I think she's getting tired, having put in a few extra elements at the beginning of the routine.
Well, she did well to hold on to that routine because it's got to be a little unnerving to make a mistake, you know, in your first one or two movements.
Yes, it is hard, and I think she had to think pretty quickly about what she was going to do about it as well. Normally capable of scoring above a 9.5 on this apparatus. The score might be a little bit more modest this evening, but full points to her for holding it together and keeping the bar routine moving. Running out of steam a tiny bit at the end.
Well, she managed to salvage the routine and Lisa Skinner with a 9.287. Across on the beam, this is Elvira Teaser of France.
Watch this movement here. This is original, full twisting, Corbett Salto sideways.
And is... makes it look so easy.
Flip, layout, flip. Change leg ring jump, a bit hesitant on the landing. Wolf jump and the Corbett fall, this time lengthways across along the beam. Just a few of her skills here, having some minor landing deductions. Change leg leap and another Corbett flick. Dismount.
An interesting routine that perhaps lacking a little bit of polish throughout.
She did make most of her connections, so that was a positive thing for her, and it never helps if you've got a signature element to impress the judges. A little bit different on the mount here. Not a high value, but a bit interesting. Very, very difficult. She has to sort of gain forwards as she jumps. Full twist, hits the beam, and circling backwards around.
Pretty impressive. And Teza awarded a 9.025 from the judges. So the results at the halfway mark of the competition, and Horodini still leads the way. Alana Slater making her move in round two. She's in second, and then the Chinese, Hui Yuan Wan, in third. Then we have Esther Moyer, Izarescu. Well, we expected a little more from her, but she still has two apparatus to move up the standings. Then the second of the Chinese, Emily Fournier, a good performance so far, of Canada in seventh, and Jenny Smith of Australia in eighth.